Before the Airbus A320 and Boeing 737, there was this. A jet so elegant, so advanced, it quietly changed aviation forever. But unlike the Concorde or the 707, the world forgot it. This is the story of the Sud Aviation Caravelle, the French masterpiece that shaped the jet age without ever asking for attention. The year is 1951. The world was getting ready for jet airliners. Boeing and Douglas were building massive jets for long-haul routes. But in France, a group of engineers had a different vision. Why not make a short-haul jet instead? Something faster and quieter than the old propeller aircraft still dominating European skies? So the French government issued a competition. And one company stood out, Sud-Est Aviation, which would soon become Sud Aviation. Their design was like nothing anyone had ever seen. The design was sleek, clean, and futuristic. But the real genius? The engine placement. Instead of mounting the engines on the wings, Sud Aviation moved them to the rear fuselage, making it the first commercial jet to do so. This means quieter cabins, less vibration, cleaner wing airflow, and therefore better fuel efficiency. The wings were smooth, the fuselage streamlined, and the triangular cockpit windows? So iconic, they'd later inspire Airbus designs. The aircraft was named after a traditional Mediterranean sailing ship, the caravelle. And in 1955, it took to the skies for the first time. A new era had begun. By 1959, the caravelle was in commercial service with Air France and Scandinavian Airlines. It was the first jet ever to operate short routes across Europe, from Paris to Rome, London to Geneva, Oslo to Stockholm. Passengers loved it. It was quiet, smooth, modern. And airlines loved the quick turnarounds and better economics. It proved that jet travel wasn't just for crossing oceans, it could be for everyday flying too. More than 280 caravels were built. It was exported all over the world, Africa, South America, the Middle East, and even Asia. Later versions had more powerful engines, longer range, and updated avionics. But at its core, it was still the same graceful aircraft that started it all. And here's the twist. The caravelle's layout, rear engines, low wings, T-tail. That design would become the blueprint for jets like BC-111, DC-9. Every time you fly in a CRJ or an ERJ, you're flying in a machine inspired by the caravelle's genius. By the 1980s, newer jets took over. The caravelle couldn't keep up with the fuel efficiency and capacity of the 737s and A320s. It quietly retired from passenger service. Some continued as VIP or military aircraft for a few more years. Today, a few are preserved in museums. Their engines silent, but their legacy lives on in every jet that came after them. The caravelle didn't chase headlines. It didn't break speed records. But it did something far more important. It proved that jet travel could be everyday, accessible, and beautiful. It may not be remembered like the Concorde, but without the caravelle, aviation would look very, very different today. If you love the story of aviation brilliance, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to our channel. Tell us in the comments, which classic airliner do you want us to cover next? Because here, aviation history is just taking off.